From, it's a little town close to Oregon and Marsh. I can't remember the name of the town.
Eustisford.
No, that town. Anyway, she's a pretty good muskrat trapper from what I hear. And she has her own YouTube channel, who her dad features prominently in, usually as the foil of the whole thing. But they're kind of fun to watch. So it's Trapping Squad, is that it? And she'll talk a little bit about it, I'm sure. Anyway, if you guys will all welcome Michelle.
Hi, I'm Michelle Sharp, and I'm from Southern Wisconsin. I did a little trapping when I was young, but 3 years ago it became a passion for me, and something I look forward to every year. 3 years ago, I went muskrat trapping for the first time, and when me and my dad were sitting by a muskrat hut, the trap that we just set in the water tripped, and when we pulled it up, there was a muskrat in it. This got me excited and made me want to trap more. So today I will be showing you three of my favorite muskrat sets that can be used in different times of season and scenarios. This is a colony trap. It has two doors facing inward that allows the muskrat to go in, but does not allow it to come back out. I like to set these more than conibears because unlike conibears, they can catch more than one muskrat at a time. So to set one of these, you will have to find a muskrat run or bank run. A muskrat run is where the muskrats will run on the bottom of the water. And to find these, sometimes you will see them, and other times if the water is cloudy, what I'll do is I'll put my foot down looking for the deeper part, and it will usually be more solid. Now to find the muskrat bank then, I can follow the muskrat run, or I can put my foot along the shoreline looking for the little indent in the shoreline. If you can find the bank den, you will want to set it closer to the bank den so that the muskrat will go through your trap and will be able to go around. So if the bank den is where the little pine tree branch is and the run is right there, you'll want to put it in the center of the run, and you want to make sure it's not upside down like this, because if it's upside down, the doors will be open and the muskrat will be able to swim straight through your trap, never getting caught. So you will want to make sure it's facing upward and also in the center of the run, so it won't be able to go around your trap. So to stick these traps, I will use this 8-foot tall fiberglass rod, and I'll stick it through the side of the trap into the water. The wire won't be here on the stake, but it's just on the stake.
Michelle, why do you use an 8-foot stake?
So it's really tall, and we spray paint the top, so it's a little light, so you're able to see it, especially if we use these during winter, which again, we expect you to put. When we use these during winter with the snow, and since it's white and it's really tall, so we lose it. So I don't like to use my gauntlets because they are cold, and I will usually go over my gauntlets. So to pick up the trap, to check it, I will use this carp shooting arrow, which has these two barbs on the side, on the tip of it, and I'll reach down into the water, hook the trap, I'll bring it up, check the trap, and then put it back down in the water. Now, you can also do these sets during the winter, and again, you will want to find muskrat runs. So, during the winter, since you can't see through the ice sometimes, you will want to look for bubble trails. Now, bubble trails are when the muskrats will swim, air will collect in their fur, and the bubbles in the air will go up to the ice, and when you chop it open, sometimes it'll also be the ice will be thinner where the muskrats are swimming through. So, yeah. Mm-hmm. Now, some states do not allow colony traps, but you can do the same setup with so you'll want to look for the muskrat bait can again. So what I will do is to find it. I will put my foot along the shoreline until I feel the indent. So after I find the bait then, I'll set the trap. So once I set the trap, I'll turn it downward like this, and you want to make sure that the triggers are towards the top of the trap. So I'll put my foot in the bank deck. So I'll stick it down into the water until I feel it hit my foot. And when it hits my foot, I'll move my foot out of the way and stick it down the rest of the way into the water. You want to make sure it's right up against the bank deck so the muskrat is not able to go around your trap and they have no choice but to go through your trap. So, any questions on the colony or the
bear? What size trap are you using right there?
This is a 160. Sometimes I'll use 150s, but this is a 160.
Why the 160 rather than the 110?
Because they're bigger traps, so it will cover the whole the bank thing better. Any other questions? So my next trap is a 1.5 coil spring foot hook trap. To set one of these, you either will have to find a muskrat head, feed bed, or toilet. So a muskrat hut is a big pile of cattails and mud that is hollowed out by the muskrats in order for them to live in it. So it's kind of like this, but it'll usually be about this much bigger. So my setup I have with these traps is I have this 8-foot tall fiberglass rock with this 3-foot cable extension attached to the trap. And then attached to the trap, I have another little cable extension with this keychain type thing that I'll ring around the wire. So it's an easy attachment for the traps. So once I find the muskrat head, so how you know it's being used is there'll usually be little mud climb up spots that lead into the water. So usually be 2 to 3 of these on a muskrat hut. I will usually set all of them if I have the necessary traps to do so. So once I find the climb up spot, I want to set it
an inch or less under the water. Because if it's any deeper, the muskrat will go over your trap. And if it's any higher, the muskrat could see your trap and avoid the trap. So, when you set these, you want to also make sure it's at a slight angle, so if the muskrat does get caught in your trap, that it won't hit the jaw and it won't get caught. So, for staking these traps, you want to stake them as far as you can away from your trap and from anything you can tangle on, like cattails or logs or anything that I can really tangle on. So I will stake it as far as I can away from any of that stuff so it won't tangle on it. Because the muskrat will dive down and you don't want it to tangle up on anything and not drown. So you want your muskrat to drown. So another place I will set with these traps are muskrat feed beds. Now, the feed beds will usually be smaller piles of cattails, so kind of like this, and that the muskrats will eat on. So how you know it's being used is there will be little pieces of chewed up cattail, little white pieces, and the white pieces are the inside of the cattail. So kind of like the muskrat head, you will want to set where they're climbing up. And again, you want to make sure the trap's at an angle and staked far away. Now the last spot I will set with these traps are muskrat toilets, which can be anything from cattails to rocks to logs. And how you know it's being used is there will be muskrat poop on it, which is about the same size as a raisin. So you again want to set where they're climbing up and at an angle and stake far. Sometimes I will use some of my homemade lure, which is just Vaseline and cherry oil, on these traps. But yeah. You can also use long strings, but I prefer to set coil strings because it's easier for me to compress with my setters and the set. Any questions?
What's your favorite set to set?
For muskrat?
Yeah.
Probably colony traps. Because they're easy. Any other questions? Cherry.
Michelle, what's the system that you're using to put it onto the pole?
For this trap. So attached to the trap I have a cage bracket, and under the trap I have a fencing clip so it won't fall off the stake.
And that's movable?
Yeah. It's very easy to move. So my last set is conveyors under the ice. Now to set one of these, you want to find a muskrat hut. And once you find the muskrat hut, you want to look for the run, which again you can find through buffalo trails. Or what I'll do is if I can't see buffalo trails, I will hit around the hut with the spud bar until I hear a hollow noise. So once I hear the hollow noise, I will want to bust a hole for my trap. Now, I like to use my hatchet because it's very lightweight. I like the spud bar. And although it will take longer, it's very lightweight and way easier to hit.
Is it fun?
So bear that in mind, guys.
So once I chop my hole, I will want a big brush on here.
You want to make sure it's not set when you bait it. No. So, I will use carrots to bait my sets because they're light colored and they'll stay on the triggers better. We did use apples, but they would rot and fall off of the triggers, so we stopped using them. So you want to put the carrot halfway up the triggers. And so once you bait it, you want to set your trap. So after you set it again, you want to turn it downwards. So placement is probably one of the most important things with this set, because if you put it too high, when there's ice, it will freeze in your trap and it won't trip if a muskrat goes by it. But if you put it too low, the muskrat will go over it and it won't notice your bait. Now another thing is why you want to put it right under the ice is because when ice freezes over, the muskrats will swim just under the ice. And when there's not ice, they'll swim on the bottom of the water. But when there is ice, you want to put it about an inch under the ice. So, for example, if like the ice is where the bottom of my hand is, you want to put your trap about right there. So it's just low enough that it will freeze, but it's high enough that the muskrat will go over it and not see your trap. So then, once you do that, once you stick it in the ground, yeah.
And it's all set, huh?
Yep. Yes. Oh, so you want to make sure the triggers are at the top of your trap, because when the muskrat sees your bait, they'll put their feet down at the bottom of your trap and start eating the carrot. So you don't want it at the bottom, so that they won't put their feet on the trigger. Any questions? Yeah. Probably the center, because then it's not, the center.
When you're asking, do you ever not bait them?
I usually always do. Any other questions?
Are grandma's carrots the best?
Yes. No. The only thing we've tried other than grandma's are apples.
Is there some particular reason why you turn the rods away?
Just so, because it will also go farther under the ice. When you turn them upward, it's also like that. So we prefer to turn them up.
What's your best year on this one?
Probably like last year, which was like,
come on, Dad, you're still
Dad remembers.
Did you ever
want to know the answer to that?
It
was
80-something.
80-something, like 85 or something.
You put up all your own muskrats?
Yeah, we'll put them up. That's pretty much the only thing we'll put up.
What does put them up mean?
There you go, ask
them. What does put them up mean?
So once you skin them, we'll flush them, so we'll get all the fat off the skin, and then we'll
hang them to dry.
Okay. Thank you.
Skin them.
Where do you hang them to dry?
In our basement.
Is there anywhere else you can hang them to dry other than my basement? Where our laundry is. Oh, okay.
Kitchen, yeah. Kitchen, your living room.
Okay. Anything else? What?
Can you tell us about your YouTube channel?
I was going to get there.
Oh, okay.
Good answer.
Okay, any other questions? Okay, well, thank you all for listening. Make sure you go check out my YouTube channel, Trapping Spot, because we'll also learn how to set other traps for other animals. And thank you for letting me do this demo.